Alright, everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Black Closet. It's been a few days since I have played this game and I don't remember anything. I think it was determined that we need to go to the greenhouse, right? This is something. We're searching for something and it's in the greenhouse. Where is my mouse? Where did my mouse go? There we go. And then. Of course not. Okay. Well, we're up a little bit higher at least with the chance to successfully find something. Why is my mouse doing that? Okay, so with this one, I think we need to. Okay, it held, but Keisha did not break. Okay, so then we were going to, I believe. Suspend. And then over here, these two is being forwarded. Althea, friendly attendant, was confident in her skills, admitted to seeing the message. It might still be on her phone. And then she went into Janelle's room, and then Janelle's cell phone was located and purged. Excellent. Which means we move on to Simone. And then. And then for this one, Janine reports that her roommate Tracy. Why is my mouse not moving? Okay. She's never returned to their room last night. Her whereabouts are currently unknown. She might be lost or injured or even kidnapped. Does her best friend have any information? Okay, so we will. Oh, dang. Well, I'd like to move on with that one. So we'll give both of those and then talk with her. Sign. There we go. And then we will inspect Tracy's room. All right, we should be good. Hopefully. School loses one reputation. So we have 75 and 49. Okay, yeah, someone forwarded me something naughty, but I deleted it. And then she hardly has anything. That should be easy. Yeah, somebody forwarded me something naughty, but I deleted it. I think she said something about a private party. Don't find any clues. But where was she? Is absent. Oh, wonderful. That's fucking great. All right. So, these two. We still have to talk to Tracy, but for now, we will harass. Are they both? They're both 100%, so I don't think it really matters. And then that's all we can do. I don't have the email anymore. I forwarded it to Mavis and then I deleted it. Look, I'll show you. You check her phone. It's clean now. Has been neutralized. And now we can question, harass, or stalk Mavis. And why is my. God dang. What is with my mouse today? No new information to report, and now I have my full team back. And then, with did I go into Kesha's room? Was con okay, and then found the doll full of pens. Okay, so we're pretty much done with this until she's back from her suspension. So now we have to harass Mavis. Then it'd be ideal to harass Simone too. Just to neutralize all targets. And then we need to question Tracy. And I believe we already went through Tracy's room, didn't we? Search Tracy's room, yeah. Okay. So, in that case, Rowan, what I'm gonna have you do. Let's go to supply closet because we need some stuff. something. We need something. So, this should be a piece of cake. Fine, you can look at my phone, but it's not a big deal. Sheesh, you deleted the forwarded email from her phone. That's another one down. Matrix is no longer a target, and the cake's perfect. So now we just need to harass Simone. I don't have the email anymore. I forwarded it to Kiana. God damn, girls. Stop fucking forwarding stuff. These girls in this fucking school. I was out doing stuff. This is suspicious. Yes, it is. And we're gonna go ahead and take the baseball bat. Excellent, everyone's. Okay, when you arrive to the dormitory common room, Teresa has already staked out her territory, a small tea set and a plate of puffy, colorful macarons. Macarons? I know it's different from macaroon. I can't talk. Hold pride of place on the coffee table. Hi. Men in movies always have beer and chips while they're watching their football. I thought this was the logical alternative. They were the prettiest thing in the bakery. So I can actually be really flirty with her, apparently. Do I want to be flirty with... I kind of accidentally ended up on this route, so why not just go all the fucking way? Let's go ahead and... There we go. But I'm not for eating. Don't laugh! Apologize. We'll apologize. Well, sit down. You take a seat on the couch and sip at the green tea Teresa has provided. When does the show start? It's not a show, it's a sporting event. We've still got time. I suppose I should turn it on and mute the sound. Images snap into focus on the screen, actors miming the values of their hand wipes and artificial drinks. Teresa doesn't seem interested in small talk, instead keeping her attention on the common room entrance. A pair of raucous girls barge into the room and freeze in mid-laugh when they see the two of you holding court by the television. They withdraw to a quiet corner to whisper to each other. Oh, here we go. It's starting. Look at Sandra's costume. Dark red must be her favorite color. I think every other dress she's worn has turned out that shade. That's extremely low cut. Those bands across the middle look strange. They're not judged on their costumes. I think I might comment on low cut only because we are supposed to be the student council president, and so dress code might be like a thing that we have to... Modesty fabric. At least, I'm pretty sure it is. She's got a very good skin tone match, but right there's a faint shadow, I think. With some skaters, the modesty panels are really obvious, and even the spectators in the stands can probably see them, but it makes the color lines more dramatic. Look, there's no navel, right? So that has to be fabric, probably. I love skating costumes, not just the dresses, but the men, too. There's so much variation, and people aren't afraid to try new things. The best tell a story with everything they're wearing. And because they're constantly in motion, the skirts and sleeves can be designed to billow dramatically in the breeze. It's so pretty. I wish I could dress like that. Do you want to be a figure skater? No, not really. I've had lessons, but only through basic skills. International. Whoa. Hey! Well, I guess we missed that part. You might want to, like, try to pause and read it. I did not mean to do that. I'm sorry. Now, she's going to start her program. One after another, skaters parade across the ice, demonstrating their skills in leaps and twists. Teresa occasionally comments on one skater or another, trying to explain the details of the sport to you. See, Adam hasn't been ranked in seniors before this year, so it'll be a big upset if he medals. Also, he has a quad toe, but can't land a triple axel. Isn't quadruple better than triple? It is worth more points, but the axel is harder for some skaters because it's the only jump that takes off in different directions. Obviously, you want both for the best marks. By the end of the night, the boy Teresa was cheering for comes in second, but the rest of it is all running together a bit in your mind. Okay, options. Okay. Again, weak. So he was caught sneaking off campus to drink. It's a scam. God damn it. Wonderful. Wonderful. I'm gonna fucking lose. I'm not even gonna make it to an ending. Frida Renee came to the class recently, but suspiciously similar injuries have they been fighting? Notice Tanisha looking at her cell phone and giggling to herself. Oh, these girls, these girls, these girls. Okay, so we're not gonna worry about. Oh, wait. Wasn't this one that we spent suspended from school, so. Alright, whatever. Oh, maybe it was Kiana? Janelle's room, ambiguous. Salt purged. Okay. Observed looking at her cell phone and giggling. No longer had a message. Okay, so we have that. So we're just gonna go straight to harassing because we need to get this fucking down. 11! We have 11 school reputation. If I fuck up big any, like, one more time, we're fucked. I still have several months of the school year left. Like, it's January. This will probably run until May or early June. Oh man, we're screwed. I'm not gonna make it through the end. Frida. Frida came to class with suspicious injuries. Have they been fighting? So they'll both probably ignore me. We're gonna have them stalked. Get supplies. And then we'll move on. Okay. Fine, you can look. Awesome. She's been neutralized. Fine, you can look. No big deal. Has been neutralized. No longer the target in this case. It seems to have been contained. Yes. Yes. So, follow her. It doesn't seem to notice you following, but you don't learn anything new. Damn it. Well, we already have one of those, so we'll take that. He is absent due to stress. Barge into my office. Why? It's not fair. What's not fair? The skating. Do you remember the competition we watched? How Adam came in second, and it was his first senior competition, and he did a really great job. Well, they've just announced the official U.S. teams for Worlds this year, and he's not on it. They gave his slot to Dominic Richards, who came in 13th. Why did they do that? Because Dominic was third at Worlds last year, but he was injured this year, which is why he was skating so badly. So the officials gave him a free pass to be on the team anyway. What's the point of having a competition if you're going to throw out the results and pick the person you like best? Reliability matters too. But he's not reliable, or he wouldn't have come in 13th. He could do just as badly at Worlds. I bet they think he's nice and that he deserves to go, and they don't care at all what anyone else deserves. I'm not nice, normal. Damn it! That was my fault. There are things I want to do, but what if I can never exceed just because people don't like me? Be too excellent to ignore. I suppose if you shine brightly enough, even a pathetic pea brain has to recognize you eventually. Thanks, Elsa. She leaves. All right. So with that, we might be able. So if I go search, and then I put that on. Yas. All right. So everyone was neutralized in that one, so then we will question her and then harass. Come on. There we go. Harass her. And hope for the best. Quietly search the greenhouse for clues. Aha, there's an out-of-the-way maintenance door that's been left unlocked. Excellent. Finally, some fucking progress. Oh, sorry, we were practicing for rugby tryouts the other day. I guess we got some bruises. Looks like there's no mystery after all. Excellent. Now that you find a way to steam tunnels, you can search for evidence. The well-known best friends Luna and Natasha... I'm gonna say that's Natasha. Have been conspicuously avoiding each other. Maybe there's that... Make sure that nothing is dramatically wrong. Isha returns to school. She complains to school's heavy treatment to anyone. Oh, fuck. Alright, then. Like, we're, like, on the downward side. I mean, we might as well just fucking go for it fully. So, Luna... Right. Okay, so then go ahead and question her, and then for steam tunnels, I'm gonna have to use search. That's a 55. What if we did stake out? Unknown. What if we paired the two together? Nothing. Alright, well, I might as well just go for it. Get supplies. And we're good. Oh no, she hasn't done anything specifically wrong, it's just creepy. Has been neutralized and she's no longer a target. I think Natasha's jealous because I've been spending time with other people. Hot poking. Oh shit! Even for a council member, that's instant detention. Okay, so we will take the hall pass. And everyone's absent due to stress, but we can harass Gretchen. Well, no, she okay, and has. There we go. I lost 10 karma and 6 reputation. Because I assumed that she was in the wrong, which fucking sucks. I'm stupid. So. We will question her nicely, and then we will search again, and then with that, but then we don't have enough of observation. Okay, so what if we do stakeout? And for stakeout, where is my mouse? We're gonna take that off and get a gauge. And then we'll have her question, and then we're gonna have Teresa go to the supply closet. Okay. So, success. Luna is ignoring me, and I don't know why. 118. You hide carefully and watch for signs of activity in the tunnels. You don't spot any students down there, but learn the patterns of the maintenance staff makes it easier to avoid detection next time. Excellent. Okay, so I don't know what's going on, but it's not my business. Alright. And then we'll go ahead and take Veiled Threat. Everyone's relaxing. Has heard saying that her friends... Aline and Judy are planning a surprise that will shock and investigate urgently. Mysterious package has been delivered to the student council office. And before we see that, I believe we are out of time. So I'm going to end it here. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.